The cover and flare system is really a great system for any farm to utilize, provided that they have the level of management to do so. It not only reduces the amount of rainwater that that farm's hauling with its manure, but also it reduces the amount of greenhouse gas emissions by burning off the methane.
As we increase herd size, we needed more manure storage to effectively apply the manure, and we built a large earthen storage in 2003, and we spent a couple years being frustrated with the odors that were coming off of the manure storage, and it's pretty much in close proximity to our village and neighbors, and we became increasingly concerned about what we could do to try to mitigate those odors. As soon as the cover was installed, the odors went away. Basically, from the time the manure leaves the cow, it never sees the light of day again.
Well, we had an existing manure pit for quite a while. The addition we made a couple years ago, which would include the cover on top of our existing storage, the separator system, we made that for a number of reasons. We know we want to limit our inputs and improve on our output so we can keep the farm in balance for our nutrients. We realized that we bring in a lot of sawdust when we were bedding with sawdust, and we didn't get the optimal results we wanted with sawdust. We saw a lot of our neighbor farms doing very well using separated solids, and we wanted to try that for our farm.
The system that Tim Fezzenden has here is basically all the manure is collected that's generated on this farm. And then it's transferred to a reception pit in a manure processing building. And manure that's in that reception pit is pumped through a series of screw press separators. And those separated solids go to his composting operation. And he actually sells compost. There's also another stream. The solids from that separator go into a rotary drum bedding recovery unit. And those are used to bed the cows and the heifers with. The liquids are pumped to a long-term covered manure storage here.
We know that we're capturing the methane. And we have a flare system that flares it off, so that's not going into the environment, which is one of the reasons New York State really wanted to have this project.
So the cover contains the gas, it's collected in a pipe, and it goes to the flare, it's combusted, and that's basically a net reduction of about 4 metric tons of CO2 equivalent per cow per year.
We also appreciate the fact that this cover that we have is keeping rainwater out. We get 30 to 32 inches of rain a year, which results in about 3.5 million gallons of rain in our manure storage, which is 3.5 million gallons of water we have to transport by truck out to the fields, which is a lot of wasted energy. So being able to not have to transport that much liquid that doesn't have a purpose is valuable too.
The benefit that we found that we didn't really expect was the increased fertilizer value of the manure that's stored in the covered storage. And primarily the nitrogen concentration is considerably higher, which does help offset some of our purchased nitrogen costs on the farm.
Bottom line, that's about $10,000 of value for a winter storage period for the covered storage.
One of the key benefits we've seen is the quality of milk we're able to produce and the comfort of level that our cows have. So we're making the separated solids into bedding material. We add quicklime to it, which brings down any bacterial level, any bacterial activity to pretty much nothing. The cows, as a result, have some really comfortable bedding, and our milk quality has really improved dramatically.
The cover and flare system that Table Rock has implemented is just a super benefit all around. Not only does it help the farm's bottom line, it helps the environmental aspect of things and makes them be better neighbors. It's just a win-win-win situation all around.
Now that we're, 10 or 12 years into this project, they gave us a 20-year life expectancy of the cover, and I'll definitely replace the cover when the day comes that it needs to be replaced. And I think probably as far as a decision on this farm, that's probably one of the better decisions for not only the farm, but for the community and the cropland all in one.